In the past 5 years, the Duterte administration has pursued an aggressive reform agenda. Among the measures passed, the Corporate Recovery and Tax Incentives for Enterprises Act, or CREATE Law, which is seen to attract more foreign investments. What more should be done to improve the business environment here in the Philippines? Joining us now, Coco Alquas, Executive Director of the Makati Business Club. Coco, good afternoon. Nice to talk to you again.
Hi, Ron. Good to see you again.
First, thanks for inviting us. Your assessment of year five of the Duterte administration in the shadow of the pandemic, what were the hits and misses?
I'd speak more generally, Ron. Obviously, year five was all about the pandemic. Mm-hmm. It was great that we passed CREATE, that we ended the uncertainty over incentives and the corporate taxes during that time. But it's really about the pandemic. And you know, that will be assessed in the future in comparison with other countries, how they did. We all know that we had a harsh lockdown. Is that the reason why we have lower cases than others? How has that affected our economy? You know, it's too early to say all of those. What I would like to say is that the private sector is thankful that the government has allowed it to offer advice and to help when possible. The best example of which is the vaccination program. That's beginning to pick up as the LGUs are climbing the learning curve, and it's picking up as the vaccines are arriving. MBC, MAP, IBPAP, Phoenix were among the business orgs that had consolidated private sector supply for the Moderna vaccines, mm-hmm. Brought in by ICTSI. None of this, of course, is happening soon enough or fast enough. Assuming that the Delta variant or future strong variants will spread, the sooner we vaccinate, the more Filipinos, the better.
Right, and that's what we're watching out for. Mm-hmm. Now, the fast recovery of the economy from this pandemic most probably will be the top concern of businesses. But what are you waiting to hear from the president in his last State of the Nation address?
You know, it's no secret, Ron, that the admin and the business sector has had an it's complicated relationship. But the admin has had, in the words of one of our principals, Toti Chikyamko of FEF, a cornucopia of economic legislation. Toti said that 3 years ago in 2019. We know that election fever will get in the way. Uh-huh. But in this final year, we think that a good way to close this book or this chapter would be actions such as, first, Biennium 3. To help the people steady themselves. Two, amendments to the Public Service Act, the Foreign Investments Act, the Retail Trade Liberalization Act. You know, CREATE, as I mentioned a while ago, has ended the uncertainty for investors. Let's roll out the red carpet and try to compete with our neighbors who have gotten a head start by amending these three laws. Representative Salceda's ease of paying taxes bill, which will help small and medium enterprises pay their taxes easily and with less harassment, good for businesses, especially small businesses, good for the government in terms of collecting taxes. I'm particular to MBC, where we are the point person within the business groups for something called FOI, Freedom of Information. The president's second EO when he came into office was his EO on Freedom of Information. It's brought the Philippines further down that road, a 30-year road, in the push for such a law. It would be a great achievement if he makes it law. Finally, we hope to hear something. This is not legislative. Fixing our schools, Ron. International tests from 2018, 2019, we've all heard about this over the last 2 years, have shown how far we're lagging. Studying from home, remote learning has not helped that. If we don't have, Ron, a well-educated citizenry and workforce, we won't have a democracy or an economy to speak of.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, you mentioned three bills a while ago, and three bills that were also mentioned by Chris Nelson. We talked to him a while ago, Chris Nelson of the BCCP, of course, and these are the PSA, the FIA, and the RTLA, and these are meant to boost the foreign investments coming in. And I just encountered this story about local businesses wanting the president to focus more on them and the economy of the recovery of the economy first before actively going after foreign investments to come in. We do want to get your thoughts on that.
It's never too early to attract investments. Obviously, the economy could be in better shape. but maybe some investors want to come in at a period like this. It's never too early to invite them in. We need them. Many of our neighbors have a head start on us. Unfortunately, we were bogged down for 3 years because we were debating corporate tax incentives and the corporate tax, and some other countries got a head start on us. There's a lot of movement from China. Plants moved out of China. We got very few of those. So I understand the point that some of these parties are making, but I don't think it's too early to do it. In fact, if anything, we need to play catch up, Ron.
Finally, Coco, I know it's still a year away, but this early, does the NPC have some sort of a wish list of what the next president should focus on? Bills and direction that President Duterte did not want to make or take in his administration?
I'm not thinking so much of what the president did or didn't do. On the economic front, as we said, a lot of good economic legislation has passed. What I would say is maybe we stop. We refocus our sights on those and think about how we want to change our situation here. The pandemic has taught us a lot. We're learning a lot during the pandemic. And rather than just fixing what's there, we should really focus our efforts on changing what needs to be changed, it's meaning spending money on certain areas, which will feed into the general recovery while also paving the way for a more sustainable future. I'm talking about things like education. We've talked about that already. Digitalization, we've talked about, everyone's talking about that. Mm-hmm. Unemployment insurance and other worker benefits, fixing PhilHealth. These are the kinds of things. They're not purely economic. They're more economic and social. But these are the kinds of initiatives that the next president should focus on in order to create a more sustainable development for the country, a more sustainable economy, a more solid democratic Philippines, Ron.
Coco Alcuas of the Makati Business Club. Thank you for talking to us, Coco.
Thanks, Ron.